1995, the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charity's Banquet. I'm sitting here with none other than Bill Frisella, who is the president of the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities, and he's also president and co-founder of Metro Lighting, which, and he's, Bill's been on the show, and a great supporter of Casa Cucina over the years. Bill, the banquet, 1995 St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities banquet. It's beautiful. We're at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. What a beautiful place to have a banquet.
Yes, it sure is, Keith. It's just a splendid place to hold a banquet. We're going to have more than 400 guests here tonight, including our honorees, Charlie Gito, Charlie Fazio, and Dominic Galati.
And they're going to be joining us a little bit later on the show. But for right now, Bill, I want to present you with this, you as president of the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charity. The certificate of appreciation is so hot, you know, it's so hot, these things. Anyway, we hereby express our sincere appreciation to the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities for maintaining a positive image of the Italian-American awarded at the Italian Open Golf Tournament banquet at Ritz-Carlton Hotel this 30th day of July, 1995. And this is given to you, to the officers and the board members of the Open, the IO, the Italian Open, on behalf of the Il Pensiero, Antonino Lombardo, who is the chief editor, our Italian newspaper, and myself, Casa Cucina, Keith Ballentine, our Italian American television program. And Bill, and folks out there, the Italian Americans that are portrayed, or the Italians that are portrayed on television, are not the ones that you see in the movies or read about in the books or in the magazines or the newspapers. Folks, these are Italian Americans. The Bill Frisellas, the John Vitales, and the Joe Tangueros, and the Pasta House Boys, Charlie Fazio, and the list is endless. Hardworking Italian Americans.
Well, thanks a lot, Keith, for all those nice comments, and it's quite an honor to receive this award on behalf of the board of the Italian Open.
A group of beautiful, beautiful people. Why don't we just briefly go over the chairman of the board is Joe Tangero.
Yes, Joe Tangero was one of the original founders back in 1973. He's still a member. Joe, as many of you may know, is afflicted with ALS, and he's confined to a wheelchair now. But he's one of the hardest workers on the entire board, you know, even with his condition.
And you're the president. Vice president
is Tom Caradona. Chief operating officer is John Vitale. Nick Lacavoli is our treasurer.
The treasurer, a group of wonderful businessmen in St. Louis here. They come together to raise money. And I understand up to this point, Bill, you've raised over $1,100,000.
Right, and hopefully this year we'll get up to the $1,200,000 mark. It's going to be a huge success this year by just pure numbers. We should have close to 350 golfers again tomorrow. We had 380 golfers last year, which was the largest charity golf tournament ever held in St. Louis, or maybe the Midwest. And we've kept that number down to 350 just because of the way the course plays.
Now, this year's honorees are Charlie Fazio. We're going to have Charlie Fazio and his beautiful wife, Glennis, on the show. We're going to have Giovanni Dominic Galati on the show with his wife, Jackie. And we're going to have Charlie Gito and his beautiful wife, Annie, on the show a little bit later on. So, folks, io sono Kito Valentino e questo è Guglielmo Frisella, Presidente of St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities, and questa è Casa e Cucina. Sit back and enjoy a great Italian-American show.
Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce, gente delle anni. Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce, lavoriamo, mangiamo, beviamo, cantiamo, balliamo, festeggiamo insieme. Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce, gente italiana. Lavoriamo, mangiamo, beviamo, cantiamo, balliamo, festeggiamo insieme. insieme. Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce. Gente italiana.
Charlie Fazio was born in St. Louis, the son of Giuseppe and Concentino Fazio. Charlie is the owner of Joe Fazio Bakery, which was founded by his grandfather, Vincenzo Di Mare, in 1902. In 1926, Charlie's father took over the business from his father-in-law and ran it for some 35 years. In 1961, Charlie assumed control of the family business and has been running it ever since. Under his able guidance, the bakery, which has been in existence on the Hill for the past 91 years, continues to flourish and has become a landmark within the Italian-American community. Charlie lives in West County and is married to the beautiful Glennis Fazio. Their two sons, Charles Jr. and Joseph, are very much involved in the family business. Their daughter, Suzanne, has completed school and looks forward to joining the bakery as well. Charlie Fazio is a member of the St. Louis chapter of Unico and Chow, the Civic Italian American organization. The limits of his generosity knows no bounds. He has helped virtually hundreds of organizations through his donations and contributions of money and product. He has helped every Italian American organization in the St. Louis area, as well as many other institutions, schools, and hospitals, some of which include the City of Hope, the Leukemia Society, Multiple Sclerosis Association, the Muscular Dystrophy Association, and the American Cancer Society. Let's meet Charlie Fazio and his beautiful wife, Glennis. Another one of the recipients of the 1995 St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities Award is none other than Mr. Charles Fazio, and he's here with his beautiful wife, Glennis Fazio. Piacere.
Grazie.
Now, Fazio's Bakery has been an institution in the St. Louis area since 1902. It began with your grandfather.
My grandfather, right. My grandfather, Vincenzo Di Mare, started it. He actually was in partners with a gentleman named John Pizzoni. That's how they actually got started.
Now, as I understand it now, in 1902, your grandfather worked it for 29 years?
No.
Was it 25 years?
24 years, actually. No, well, he died in 1925, so 23 years. Yeah, 23 years.
And then your father.
And my father had come over about a year previous to him, my grandfather dying. My father came over, and the way the situation went is somebody told my grandfather, Vincenzo, that there was this young man in Italy that was a good worker, a good person, and all that. And if my grandfather could get hold of him and have him come to work for him, he thought it'd work out real well. Well, they looked for him and they found out that he wasn't in Italy; he was in Sandusky, Ohio. So they've got hold of him in Sandusky, Ohio, and he told my father, he says, "Come on to St. Louis, work for me. If you work out, I'll send you back to Italy, introduce you to my daughter, and you can marry her and then bring her back." They had never met.
It's Concentina.
Right. So
35 years they worked in the business.
Until 1961.
And then his son, you, mm-hmm, been working here since 1961.
61, right. Well, actually...
34 years.
Yeah, well, actually, you know, I started like 9 years old, so I started a little bit before. You know, I started driving a truck when I was 13 years old.
Glennis, yes. Beautiful wife of Charlie.
God love you for that.
She's, I love this lady. She watches a lot of TV, too. She told me. Has there ever been a shortage of bread in the house?
Yes.
Oh,
I have been
goodness.
Known to give bread away to my neighbors and 2 days later go back and say, you know them 12 loaves of bread I gave you? Can I have one of them back? Because he has sold it. He'd rather sell it than bring a loaf of bread home to me. Well, I sold it all.
I always wondered about that, having a bakery and having a shortage of bread. I wanted to ask you, you must be very proud to have a husband that contributes so much to the community, as well as having your sons working at the bakery and a beautiful daughter.
I am. I really, you know, it was rough. It was rough for many, many years, but it's easy now. It's good. And you know, it's one good thing about getting old. You finally get to that point where you can take it a little bit easier and do what we want to do.
The Conseil Cucina, we hand out an award. You're getting an award here tonight from the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for charities. But on the television show here, on behalf of the Italian American Media Foundation here in St. Louis, Antonino Lombardo, the Open Sierra, and myself of Conseil Cucina, this is a certificate of appreciation for maintaining a positive image of the Italian American folks. These are Italian Americans that work hard, they have a dream, they go for that goal, and the most important thing to these people is the church, the family, and the community, and this is a fine example of those three things right here, very much involved with their church, and their family, and their community. So, also, you're getting this award here tonight. We have the certificate of appreciation, Charlie, and I admire you very much, and I'm very honored to give you this award.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Do appreciate it.
Let's say goodbye to everybody. Let's get into a little music here now, okay?
A te, dinda luce calde, sto solo do.
Charles E. Gito Sr., the affable proprietor of Charlie Gito's Pasta House and co-owner of Charlie Gito's on the Hill, is a lifetime resident of St. Louis. His proud Italian heritage can be traced to a neighborhood rich in tradition. He is the son of Francesca Mugavero and the late George Gito. His memberships include the Missouri Athletic Club, Unico National, parishioner of St. Ambrose Church, and the Basilica of St. Louis the King, the Old Cathedral. Charlie and his wife of 42 years, Anna Marie Russo, opened Charlie Gito's Pasta House in 1978. In 1981, Charlie, Annie, and their son Charlie Jr. opened Charlie Gito's on the Hill. These restaurants are frequently a regular stop for many local and visiting professional athletes, including the Los Angeles manager Tommy Lasorda, who has become a close friend. Although his pride in his restaurants is evident, Charlie's greatest pleasure comes from his and Annie's four children, each of whom is following in his footsteps in the restaurant business, and their 10 grandchildren. Sons John and George, along with son-in-law Jim Vangel, can all be found at the downtown restaurant, while Charlie Jr., along with his mother Annie and sister Karen Gito Vangel, operate the restaurant on the hill. Charlie has generously contributed to his community. Because of his great civic involvement, he has received many prestigious awards and commendations. Among them is the Spirit of Life Award by the City of Hope, Grand Marshal of the St. Louis Annual Columbus Day Parade. He has been honored by the St. Louis Chapter of Unico as Man of the Year and honored by the St. Louis Italian Club. The project closest to his heart is the Charlie Gito Invitational Classic, an annual golf tournament that benefits St. Mary's High School. When Charlie is not at the restaurant, you can find him out at the CNA Ranch in Lundell, Missouri, where he enjoys riding his horses. Now let's meet Charlie Gito and his beautiful wife, Anna Marie. Another recipient of the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities Award is the honoree and a well-familiar face, two faces that are very familiar to the metropolitan St. Louis area, Mr. Charlie Gito and his beautiful wife, Annie. Charlie, how you doing today? And congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You know, now they've been married for, I understand, 42 years.
Right.
That's a lot of...
And 4 years we went together.
And four, that's 46 years.
That's right.
Well, now, you were the son of Francesco Mugavero.
Right. And George Gito.
And George Gito. Now, you lived on the hill? You grew up on the hill?
Yeah, we were born and raised on the hill.
Just tell the folks out there a little bit about Charlie Gito. What was it like growing up and where did you work at? I heard some stories now, so...
Well, you know...
I'm just going to match them up here.
When we were in grade school... In the eighth grade, we wanted to, you know, earn a little money, so I got to be a busboy at Ruggieri's. I was 12 or 13 years old, and I kind of liked it, you know, pretty much, and I kind of stuck with it all my life. I've never been out of the restaurant business since.
You started out as a
dishwasher, busboy.
So you learned every facet of the business.
Right. We did everything there, you know, and every job I've ever had, it's always been around the restaurant business for the last almost 50 years.
And Annie, you're of Italian descent also.
Yes, I am. My parents both came from Sicily, Catania. And I was the youngest of five.
What was your maiden name?
Russo.
And you were from the hill also?
Born at 5300 block of Bischoff. And Charlie was born 5400 block of Bischoff.
Uh-oh.
And we didn't meet till we were teenagers.
Is that right?
He went to St. Ambrose School and I went to Shaw School.
Well, there was a lot of Italian Americans that went to Shaw School.
It was a big school.
Sure. Now, Annie and Charlie here have given back to the community so much, what the community has given to them over the years, and that's one of the reasons why they're being honored here tonight. But the restaurants, when did you, the first restaurant you had was downtown on 6th Street?
No, we had a place on Macklin Avenue, 2200 Macklin Avenue, 2209 as a matter of fact, called Gito's Pizza. 1956 we opened there.
1956?
Right, and we had a little pizza place there. There was a real nice little place called Isla Capri, Gito's Isla Capri, and I bought it from a guy by the name of Sammy Antonora, and that was our first venture into business, excuse me, on our own. And it was a pretty interesting and educating situation. You know, I learned plenty.
But at the time, we were having one baby after the other, so it was kind of rough.
Well, what are those babies doing now, Annie?
The babies are all in the business with us.
That's right. Johnny, boys, Charlie Jr.,
Karen, Charlie,
Karen,
and my George. And my son-in-law, Jim Vangel.
Another truly an Italian-American family-owned business. And this is remarkable to me how two people can come together and have a dream and go for it and work so hard to achieve this. So, you know, besides receiving the award here tonight, Charlie, we would like to present to you, on behalf of the Il Pensiero, Antonino Lombardo, who's the editor, and myself, Keith Ballentine of Casa Cucina, a sincere appreciation to you, Mr. Charles Gito, for maintaining a positive image of the Italian-American awarded at the Italian Open Banquet down here at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. Actually, this is not only to you, Charlie, although your name is on there alone, it's to your wife and to your children, because all of you work. There's nothing easy about the restaurant business.
Really. I really appreciate this. This is... makes me very proud that people think of me that way. I don't think of myself that way, but it makes me very proud that me and my family, you know, that people express their kindness to us this way.
Well, you know, there's, I always say there's one thing, and you can tell fakes. You can tell people that are not very sincere with their hearts, but there's one thing Italians are good at, and that is speaking from their heart. And these are, I've known these people for years, and they're just beautiful people. So good luck with your restaurants, the Gito's on the
Thank
Hill.
You
bless. God bless you. God bless both of you.
Thank you very much, Keith.
You bet.
We have been blessed.
Yes, you have. And
Thank you.
I have too. Thanks for this interview here. say arrivederci to everybody.
Ciao.
Quando poi sono il mandolin, di lì, canterà vita bella. Danzerai, tepita, una gran barandella. Nel chiarore lunar tu vedrai marchiar questo amore. Se sconiezze, sciuscia, fan baldora che là questo amore. Ma se poi una guaiuna dirà voglio darti il mio cuore, scorda tutto e comincia a cantare questo amore, questo amore.
Giovanni Dominic Galati is an Italian classic. Just ask his famous friends and local fans who have wined and dined at his restaurants, Dominic's on the Hill and Premio in the heart of downtown St. Louis. He was born in the small town of Giardinello near Palermo, the capital of Sicily, and immigrated to the United States in 1964, bringing with him a passion for food and for life. Dominic's restaurant was a family affair. He and his lovely wife, Jackie, together with their parents, Angelo and Josephine Ferrante, spent endless hours making Dominic's one of the finest restaurants in the country. Giovanni is an active member of the St. Louis Ambassadors, Gruppo Ristoranti L'Italiani, and Di Rona, the Distinguished Restaurants of North America. Both Dominic's and Premio were honored with the Di Rona Award, the only two restaurants in the country under the same ownership to achieve this honor. Now, Giovanni extends his personal commitment from the dining room to the community as he volunteers his time and effort to numerous charities throughout the year. He has helped raise funds for the American Cancer Society, the American Heart Association, the Street of Dreams for Jewish Hospital, Multiple Sclerosis Society, Barnes Hospital, A Taste of Italy, and many, many others. Let's meet Giovanni Dominic Galati and his beautiful wife, Jackie. One of the 1995 honorees for the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for Charities is none other than Mr. Giovanni Dominic Galati and his beautiful wife, Jackie. Dominic, congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Now, we want to tell the folks out there a little bit about you. You came over to this country in 1964.
1964.
You had a dream.
Well, sure, I had a dream.
And you made that dream come true.
I think so. I work very hard and... and I achieve a lot of nice things. I have a wonderful family, and I have two restaurants.
See. And now you have two daughters.
Yes, Gina and Maria.
Gina and Maria.
Right.
And let's talk a little bit about when you first came over to this country. You worked for Tony's restaurant.
Well, actually, my first job was for, I worked for Stix Ben Fuller. I was in a kitchen for about 6 months.
And back then, did you have this goal of becoming one of the most famous restaurateurs here in the St. Louis area?
Well, when you come in this country, you don't speak any English, so you get right away, they know you're Italian, they stick you in the kitchen.
They stick you in the kitchen, right. But look where you are today, with Dominic's down there on the hill, 5101 Wilson.
Right, I've been there 25 years.
And the other restaurant downtown.
I have one downtown, Premier, I've been there 7 years.
Jackie, what do you think of your husband here receiving this award?
Well, I'm very proud of him, and I think he really deserves it, because he's always worked very hard all of his life to achieve what he has today, and his family is very proud of him.
Now, this is basically a family-owned business. The family works there.
Sure. My wife and I, we started the business.
Well, I tell you what, besides receiving being recognized by the St. Louis Italian Open Golf Tournament for our charity, he's been recognized by many, many different groups, and his contributions outnumber themselves. You know, for all the different American Cancer Society, just to name one, the Leukemia Society.
Right. I tried to give something in return for this wonderful city, and you can do them all, but I try to participate whatever I can.
And one of the things, besides receiving this award here tonight, I have something that we give out on the television show on behalf of Antonino Lombardo, who is the chief editor of the Il Pensiero, our Italian newspaper, and Casa Cucina is our Italian-American television program, and this is our sincere appreciation to Mr. Giovanni Dominic Galati for maintaining a positive image of the Italian-American. Now, Dominic was born in Palermo. Well, you're born in...
It's a little town near Palermo called Giardinello.
Now, he was born there, but...
Yes, I came here when I was almost 21.
Almost 21 years old. Yes. And he had a dream, and they're fulfilling it. Their dreams are coming true. That's the American dream. And that's why I say that the Italians are not what they are portrayed on television and so forth and so on. You hear me say this all the time. These are our Italian-Americans right here, folks. On Casa Cucina. Well, again, I want to congratulate you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And God bless you.
God bless you too. Sa benedica? Did I say it right?
Grazie. Sa benedica.
Okay. Ci vediamo.
Ciao. Arrivederci. Ciao. Grazie. Thank you.
Bill, what a banquet. It was great, wasn't it?
It was beautiful, Keith. Another huge success.
Another huge success. You know, one of the things about those items that you auction off, the silent auction, you did a great job.
Well, yes, this is the first year for the silent auction. We had a few complaints, and I think oral auctions in general get complaints at banquets like this. So we wanted to limit the number of items we had for the oral auction, so we opened a silent auction this year, and we had some beautiful items.
Well, Bill, thank you very much, and we'll take the folks over on the next show to the golf tournament itself at Norwood Hills Country Club.
Okay, great. Can't wait.
Don't stay out too late tonight, brother.
No way.
Say arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
Grazie, grazie a tutti. Io sono Tito Valentino e questa è Casa e Cucina. Everyone, thank you for tuning in today, and thank you very much for watching. We're on every week. So until next time, ciao. Arrivederci, ci vediamo, addio, ciao, arrivederci, ci vediamo, addio, il programma è finito, tanti auguri a tutte voi. Ci vediamo presto nel prossimo programma. Sì, 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 è vero. Addio a tutti. Ciao. Arrivederci. Ci vediamo.